Good evening, and welcome to the annual MLK Unity Celebration. I am Ashley Tedford, and I bring you greetings on behalf of Baton Rouge Community College and our Chancellor, Dr. Willie Smith. This event unites BRCC, Southern University, and Louisiana State University in celebration of Dr. King's legacy. Tonight, we welcome diversity, celebrate individuality, and encourage everyone to respect their fellow human beings despite our many different perspectives. We hope that our nation can move past these challenges and come together to move our country forward as Dr. King dreamt. We are happy that each of you joined us to share this special occasion. I hope you enjoy tonight's program. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, for your entertainment tonight, representing Baton Rouge Community College, Professor Eric Baskin, pianist, accompanied by student saxophonist Patrick Carpenter, with a soulful rendition of Amazing Grace.
My name is Aaron Cage. I am the president of BRCC's engineering organization, It is my pleasure to introduce tonight's keynote speaker.
Lynn Whitfield is an Emmy Award winner for Best Actress in a Movie or Miniseries for her portrayal of Josephine Baker in HBO's The Josephine Baker Story. She was the second woman of color to win this award, and Whitfield also received a Golden Globe nomination for this performance. Lynn is a four-time NAACP award winner and received numerous award nominations for her role in The Cheetah Girls. Whitfield received her BFA from Howard University and joined the theater company DC Black Repertory following her graduation. She later moved to New York and performed in several off-Broadway shows, including the acclaimed 1977 Los Angeles production of For Colored Girls Who Have Considered Suicide, When the Rainbow Is Enough, opposite Alfre Woodard. Lynn is a Baton Rouge native and resides in Los Angeles and New Orleans. Whitfield is also a long-standing member of the Creative Coalition, and she actively campaigns to defy the stereotypes and stigmas of women of color with the intent to change the dialogue of what it means to be a Black actress in Hollywood. Lynn currently recurs on ABC's The Mistresses and previously co-starred on multiple television series, including ABC's How to Get Away with Murder, Flash Forward, Heartbeat, Chasing Life, VH1's Hit the Floor, Fox's Boston Public, and CBS's Without a Trace. Feature films include the award-winning Eves by U.S. Ross, the diabolical Brandy in A Thin Line Between Love and Hate, opposite Martin Lawrence, Taking the Heat, opposite Tony Goldwyn, Tyler Perry's Madea's Family Reunion, Stepmom, and As the Laugh Out Loud, Deborah in Head of State, opposite Chris Rock. Lynn is often referred to as a diva, which she embraces, because she defines it as someone who embraces hard work, excellence, purpose, and giving and receiving love with passion. Ms. Whitfield currently stars in the hit TV show, Greenleaf.
Thank you for being here today. I am so honored to address an audience from three outstanding academic institutions in my hometown, Baton Rouge. Now, to our host, Baton Rouge Community College, I say thank you. And I just thank Southern University and Louisiana State University. I deeply appreciate this opportunity to participate in this Martin Luther King Unity Celebration. An urgent call, and I love this title, an urgent call for unity and innovation. It really resonates with me strongly and so much in my personal life. So please know that in a very real sense, I am there with you beyond this video screen, embracing this message and joining in with you. I was blessed to have been born in a city with such a rich educational tradition, traditions that have served so many so well for so many generations. And I and my family are among the thousands whose lives you have touched and have directly or indirectly bettered our lives through the institutions. Each of you in your own way has played a transformative role in reshaping the academic landscape, not only in Baton Rouge and its surrounding parishes, but all through the state, all through the nation and the world. Now, anyone who knows me, they know and can attest that if you want Lynn Whitfield to get involved in something, just say Baton Rouge. Oh, yes. My roots in this community and my loyalty run very deep, and I just wanted you to know that. You've always been the wind at my back. I was born right here in the Baton Rouge General and spent the first 5 years of my life in a family home that was recently designated as an Old South Baton Rouge landmark before we moved further out the Highland Road. And my parents, V. Jean Butler, and my dad, Dr. Valerian Smith, and my grandparents, Dr. Leo S. Butler and Estelle Duvall Butler, we're all committed to making Baton Rouge the Baton Rouge that we all love. And they've always supported and been so uplifting to it. In fact, it was in that old home on Terrace Street that I watched old movies with my grandmother Estelle and saw my destiny before me. I knew that the world would have to make room for a little brown girl from Baton Rouge to appear on that silver screen one day too. And so my own journey began. Well, I attended, it's not named that anymore, but it was called Robert E. Lee High School. And then I went to Southern University for a year. And then I went on and transferred to Howard University and became a third generation Howard grad. And wait a minute, hold up. Let me just pause right here to give a shout out to my fellow Howard alum, newly elected Vice President Kamala Harris. Yes. And then, of course, after that, and I'm being silly, I was on to New York and did For Colored Girls, and then I went on to Hollywood. But you know what? Enough about me. As I've already said, the motto of yours, innovation and unity, means so much to me. It really is so important for today, for what is going on today, for how we are impacted today. And, you know, at New Year's, I made, my word for the new year was fulfillment. And in order to have fulfillment, no matter what, you have to be in the moment. You have to be in the present. And so when I get anxious thinking about the past or what's going to happen in the future, I recite this little poem that gives me great, great, great peace. And it, and I hope it does the same for you. It goes like this. Today is ours. Let's live it. And love is strong. Let's give it. A song can help. Let's sing it. And peace is dear. Let's bring it. The past is gone. Don't rue it. Our work is here. Let's do it. The world is wrong, but let's right it. The battle hard. Let's fight it. The road is rough. Let's clear it. The future is vast. But don't fear it. Is faith asleep? Let's wake it. Because today is ours. Let's take it. So, let's just sit together right now and explore this idea of unity and innovation. Now, when I am approaching some of my roles as an actor, sometimes I just have to strip it all down, you know, and simplify it all and just get down to what does this mean? And this often takes me to the plain old dictionary or with all the innovations at our disposal. Now I just Google. And so I just wanted to go back to the simple definition of a word we've heard so much lately, unity, to unite. When I went to look up unity, it was what you expect, the state of being united or joined as a whole to bring together for a common purpose or an action. But you see, the act of unity, the verb to unite, can't happen without a unifier. So what do you call a person who unifies? The dictionary said a harmonizer. An integrator, a mediator, a reconciler, a consolidator. Unity has to start with yourself. Each individual needs to personalize, embody the qualities of unity for themselves. And listen, when I looked up the opposite of unity, here's what was listed. Disjoin, sever, disassociate, separate, disamalgamate, disintegrate, disconnect, disrupt, divide, and so on. Oh, as you can see, people that embody or embrace those words instead of unity probably aren't that great to be around. I mean, it's completely antithetical to being part of a whole, part of a family, part of a community, and part of the world. You see, when we're born, we don't know anything about discord or hate. We want to be nurtured and accepted. We are striving to be a part of something bigger. We are seeking unity. But it's difficult to be a unifier if we personally haven't aligned, haven't united to ourselves. So first, I must unify myself in what I think, in my ideals, in my goals, in my ability to process. You can look at anything. It can be the family unit. If you don't come to it with a good state of mind, with peace in your mind and a real desire to be a part of the whole, there can't be unity. And the same is true in a relationship or a marriage or being on a sports team. What about a choir? If there's no unity, it's not unified. Oh my goodness. Or in class. If we have a healthy spirit ourselves, it makes the whole that much better. It brings fulfillment. And maybe that's where united we stand and divided we fall comes into play. Maybe that's why they call it the United States of America, because we're so much stronger together. But it starts with ourselves. How do you align? How do we align ourselves? Well, you ask yourself, what are my ideals? What do I believe? Who do I want to be? How do I want to be as a human being? And when we do that, it puts us on the best footing to unite with others. When we're clear, we have vision, we're purposeful, we can achieve more, we can bring the best version to ourselves, to our friends and our family, to our relationships and marriages, to our communities, our work, our country, and so on, until we are citizens of the world. Now, a true citizen of the world was Dr. Martin Luther King. I'm sure we all know the many ways in which he acted on behalf of the greater good. And thus I will, you know, spare you from listening to the many, many accomplishments. He achieved so much before his premature death, and he died at 39. So I won't have to speak about that, but we can look at his example. Now, in celebrating Dr. King's legacy around the theme of innovation and unity, I wanted to take a closer look as to how these two work together to help us navigate the current challenges of life today. And we have quite a few. I recently came across a speech of his in which I had never heard. I had never heard this speech before, but he gave it in Memphis at a high school. And I know this is all college, but he gave some really important advice on how we align ourselves to meet the moment and create a blueprint for our lives. Here in part are Dr. King's words. This is the most important and crucial period of your lives, for what you do now and what you decide now in this age will well determine which way your life shall go. And the question is whether you have a proper, a solid, a sound blueprint. And I want to suggest some of the things that should be in your life's blueprint. Number one, in your life's blueprint, should be a deep belief in your own dignity, your own worth, your own somebody-ness. Don't allow anybody to make you feel that you are nobody. Always feel that you count. Always feel that you have worth. And always feel that your life has ultimate significance. Secondly, in your life's blueprint, you must have a basic principle of determination to achieve excellence in your various fields of endeavor. You're going to be deciding as the days and years unfold what you will do in your life, what your life's work will be. Once you discover what it will be, set out to do it and do it well. Be a bush if you can't be a tree. If you can't be a highway, be a trail. If you can't be the sun, be a star. For it isn't by size that you win or you fail. Be the best at whatever you are. Finally, in your life's blueprint must be a commitment to the eternal principles of beauty, love, and justice. Well, life for none of us has been a crystal stair, but we must keep moving. We must keep going. If you can't fly, run. And if you can't run, walk. If you can't walk, crawl. But whatever you do, by all means, keep moving. His words. And that's exactly what Dr. King did. He kept moving. He embraced his humanity, where he aligned his desires, his dreams and goals and purpose, because he had an overwhelming vision of unity for himself, his family, his community, his people, his country, and for the world. And what did he do? What did he do with the purpose and drive that was bestowed upon him, that was deposited in him, that came from within, that he fueled with his passion and overall vision of a better world? Informed by unity, the man beyond the dream understood that there can be no simple solutions to complex problems. But nonetheless, he carried a torch. He led a movement. He innovated. Now, being a word nerd that I am, I had to go back to the dictionary to see what Mr. Webster had to say about innovation. And here it is. It reads, innovation is the creation, development, and it is a very important word, this one, an implementation of a new product, process, or service with an aim of improving efficiency and effectiveness. When innovation and unity meet, the impossible can happen. As an innovator, you can choose to innovate like Dr. King for good, for unity, or not. It's optional. Yes, there is a clear contrast if technology is used in the spirit of unity or diversity and sometimes disruption. Good in every aspect of our modern lives, we can look and see how the confluence of innovation and unity merge and better our society. We can change, we can be change agents that bring strength and compassion and ease to ourselves and to others, and harmony, union, and creation. It builds and it starts with you. Hopefully this encourages you to find where you and unity meet and go beyond to continue on that path to innovate today and tomorrow, and how you use innovation to amplify your efforts. Just a start, a little direction. You are left a vision you see for yourself. And that work is yours to do for you. As innovators, you can choose to innovate like Dr. King for good, for unity, or not. It's optional, yes. There is a clear contrast if technology is used in the spirit of unity or division. And sometimes disruption is good. But in every aspect of our modern lives, we can look to see how the confluence of innovation and unity merge and better our society. We can be change agents that bring strength, compassion, and ease to ourselves and to others. Harmony, union, and creation. It builds and it starts with you. So hopefully this encourages you to find where unity meets in yourself and beyond, and how to bring out this roadmap, this blueprint today and tomorrow, and how you can use innovation to amplify your efforts. Just to start, a little direction. You are left to create the vision you see for yourself. That work is yours to do. For you. In closing, I'd like to leave you with an excerpt from a poem that was written and recited by Amanda Gorman, the 22-year-old National Youth Poet Laureate, who recited it at the inauguration of President Joe Biden and Vice President Kamala Harris. She is so eloquent and speaks to the challenges and to the promise of the unity we all seek, of a hope that our lives improve, that we innovate and make progress, how we move forward. When day comes, we ask ourselves, where can we find light in this never-ending shade? The loss we carry, a sea we must wade. We've braved the belly of the beast. We've learned that quiet isn't always peace. And the norms and notions of what just is isn't always justice. And yet the dawn is ours before we knew it. Somehow we do it. Somehow we've weathered and witnessed a nation that isn't broken, but simply unfinished. We are striving to forge a union with purpose, to compose a country committed to all cultures, colors, characters, and conditions of man. And so we lift our gaze and not to what stands between us, but what stands before us. We close the divide because we know to put our future first. We must first put our differences aside. We lay down our arms so we can reach out our arms to one another. We seek harm to none and harmony to all. Let the globe, if nothing else, say this is true, that even as we grieved, we grew, that even as we hurt, we hoped, that even as we tired, we tried. That we'll forever be tied together, victorious. Not because we will never again know defeat, but because we will never again sow division. Scripture tells us to envision that everyone shall sit under their own vine and fig tree, and no one shall make them afraid. If we're to live up to our own time, then victory won't lie in the blade, but in all the bridges we've made. This is the promise of the glade, the hill we climb, if only we dare. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, for your entertainment tonight, representing Louisiana State University, a spoken word by Calvin Marquise Morris, entitled Goddess of the Mississippi.
Across the African diaspora, there is the belief that there is various deities which rule over bodies of water, oceans, creeks, lakes, rivers. The Mississippi River feeds into the Gulf of Mexico. The Gulf feeds to the Caribbean Sea. The Caribbean Sea feeds to the Atlantic. And the Atlantic bounds North America to Africa, which is to say, to trace a lineage, follow the river. Follow where the bodies learn to cast themselves. Nobody ever drowns, only returns home. So imagine, at the bottom of the Mississippi River is a black femme, face beat for the god. She is a goddess, and make sure everybody knows it. And whenever she sings or just hums, shrines rise in her honor. And before black bodies could be lynched, she calls their souls to her, offers them a new body while their tired carcass of one is left above. At the bottom of the Mississippi, Emmett is a prince. He whistles and the ocean creatures draw near. There, he has both of his eyes and all of his teeth, and the only thing cracked open is his smile. And the goddess watches him from her ocean stoop and tells him he better come inside before the light of the moon pierces the dark of us. And she returns to cook a feast for the new arrivals. For instance, Toni Morrison shoots the shit with James Baldwin, asks him what it's like to adjust to a place where his preferred shade of men is not present. And they cackle. Even the shade here is harmless. Josephine Baker and Billie Holiday let out a sigh, barely making the last book they needed, because turns out my Uncle Larry and Uncle Alvin had the big joker in the ace of spades the whole time at the bottom of the river. My Uncle Van breathes again. He wakes up in something other than a prison cell. He waits with a bag of Cheetos he promised me before the prison industrial complex stole him from me for the last time. He shoots dice and plays spades and talks smack and sips hen and never gets drunk. And all the bodies turned ghosts when hooded men roamed free. They dance. They jig. They grind. The older heads two-step. And when Johnny Taylor starts singing, the old heads ask, "What you know about this?" Only to be silent when Aaliyah and Pop Smoke debut their new collab. Don't you get it when bloated bodies sprouted during Katrina as if calling towards God, she answered their prayers. Created a heaven for which our grandparents labored. A land of brown sugar and honey they did not have to share crop to reach. Do you get it? And everyone finds new tongues. Ones where there is no word for grief or trauma or displacement. Later in the day, the goddess gathers everyone around a dinner that stretches for miles. And everybody eats and is full-bellied. For once, no brown body starves. For once, every brown body is gathered around eating, and it is not a funeral. I cannot tell you, honestly, if us, will ever inherit this earth. But who cares when we rule all of the seas?
Good evening. Baton Rouge Community College is proud to hold this year Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Unity Celebration, and I'm so happy to celebrate and honor the life and legacy of Dr. King through confirming the union between three institutions: Baton Rouge Community College, Louisiana State University, and Southern University. Today, we are facing many challenges in our country that speak to an urgent need for unity. Witnessing the recent insurrection on the Capitol and the erosion of decorum and respect for one another's differences should bring back to our hearts and minds the principles Dr. King stood for. As an education leader in our state, we need to focus on the words of Dr. King, who stated, "The function of education is to teach one to think intensively, to think critically, intelligence plus character. That is the goal of true education." Today we celebrate Dr. King and our shared mission to educate and serve our students, community, and state. As our institution continues to be a beacon of light and hope for many, it is very important to honor those who fought and gave their lives for us to have the privilege we have today. This annual MLK Unity Celebration is the moment in time that we stop our hectic schedule to pay tribute to a man who played an important role in the well-being of humanity, Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. This moment needs to persist as we move through the next year with the teachings of Dr. King, drawing our interactions with each other, commitment to this union of education institution, and service to our community. Dr. King has been an inspiration to me, the young and old, black, white, Hispanic, men, women, children, and all cultures across this planet. His message was not just about peaceful change, but more about changing how you treat one another. At the signing of the Civil Rights Act in 1964, Dr. King famously stated, "What affects one directly affects all indirectly. I can never be what I ought to be until you are what you ought to be." So let us recommit to continue Dr. King's teaching with our hearts in the forefront, leading our intellectual thoughts about how we can continue to move our world forward with a focus on caring for all. May we, Louisiana State University, Southern University, and Baton Rouge Community College, set the example for others to follow and cherish the memory of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. and remain committed to his vision of unity for the advancement of our institutions, the city, and our great state.
Hello and greetings from LSU. I'm Interim President Tom Galligan, and it's my great honor to join you today to celebrate the spirit of unity, compassion, equality, and love that Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. dedicated his life to instilling in the hearts of each and every one of us. The profound messages and lessons that Dr. King spread across our nation and throughout the world more than five decades ago are as salient today as they ever were. we have all witnessed firsthand in recent years and even last week, a level of divisiveness, vitriol, violence, and hatred that threatens the very fabric of our society. And as horrifying as what we have witnessed is, what is perhaps as appalling is the fact that extreme polarization is increasingly becoming the rule rather than the exception. It does not have to be this way. Yes, we are living in very challenging times, and I know that it can feel sometimes as if our society is fractured beyond repair. But we must not allow ourselves to falsely believe that we are powerless to come together and find common ground. We have a tremendous opportunity right now to show our true character, to rise to the occasion, to meet this moment, and to work in unison to make today better than yesterday and tomorrow better than today. As Dr. King said, the ultimate measure of a man is not where he stands in moments of comfort and convenience, but where he stands at times of challenge and controversy. None of us are bystanders in the fight to eradicate hatred and bring about a more unified society. And today, I want to challenge everyone at LSU and across our communities to reflect upon the actions we can take, no matter how small or how big, to foster more unity and inclusiveness in the world around us. Through his words and his actions, Dr. King taught us so many invaluable lessons during his all too brief lifetime. But one of the greatest was this: every single person has the capacity to change the world for the better. So let's commit ourselves today to doing everything in our power to build upon the great progress that Dr. King made during his lifetime and the advancements he inspired so many others to make in the decades since his assassination. At LSU, we understand the critical role we play in effecting real and lasting change on our campus and in our community. And we know that it requires more than aspirational slogans or high-minded mission statements. It requires action. Our actions will speak louder than our words. Over the past year, we have taken concrete steps to make LSU a more inclusive, diverse, and equitable campus. I'm proud of the progress that we have made on our goals thus far, but our work has only just begun. On behalf of everyone in our LSU family, I want to thank our friends at Baton Rouge Community College and Southern University for partnering with us on this wonderful event today. We are never better than when we're together, and we look forward to working alongside you in the years to come to make our community a more just, equitable, and inclusive place for everyone. Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Carl Walton, and I'm the Vice Chancellor for Student Affairs at Southern University Baton Rouge. Today, I stand on behalf of President Chancellor Dr. Ray Belton and the entire Southern University family. As I reflect on the life of Dr. Martin Luther King, I am reminded of his impact and, most specifically, many of the quotes that came from him during his lifetime. One such quote is, "Life is the only force capable of transforming an enemy to a friend." This agape kind of love, this selfish, sacrificial love, a love for all mankind, is what we need and what we must strive for if we are to truly achieve unity. This partnership between Southern University Baton Rouge, Louisiana State University, and Baton Rouge Community College personify this kind of effort and the success of such efforts in the Baton Rouge educational community. Another of Dr. King's notable quotes: "The function of education is to teach one to think intensively and to think critically. Intelligence plus character is the goal of true education." As those who impact the lives of young scholars and leaders, this is certainly what we aspire to. If education serves the true purpose of facilitating critical thinking, intelligence is enhanced, and I do believe that character development will be the outcome. In my view, as we unify in purpose, it is the goal that we also be unified in a plan to uphold the principles, the philosophy, and ideals that define the life of Dr. Martin Luther King, Jr. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time we will have the presentation of the Unity Statement, which is done by each of the SGA presidents from our universities and colleges.
To call to action, the Greater Baton Rouge Community, Baton Rouge Community College, Louisiana State University, and Southern University A&M College to promote the multifarious advancements of the state of Louisiana and the education of its citizens. Whereas the collaboration and cooperation of these institutions is a mutually beneficial endeavor that enhances the quality of education, and whereas upholding the fundamental principles of collective action, servitude, and social justice employed by Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. is vital to the coexistence of these institutions, and
whereas fostering the exploration of many perspectives embodies the essential and unique attributes of the fabric of our collective experiences, and these entitles possess the skills to bridge racial, ethnic, and religious differences, and whereas it is necessary to continue unity efforts among Baton Rouge institutions of higher learning, the legislature, community organizations, and religious entities working to facilitate educational, economic, cultural, social, civil, and political rights of all citizenry. And whereas the leadership of Baton Rouge Community College, Louisiana State University, and Southern University and Agricultural and Mechanical Colleges booster an equitable educational process for all students regardless of individual differences. And
whereas each institution shall continue the vision of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. by working to collaborate on annual awareness initiatives that promote unity and diversity and strengthen the perception of solidarity. Be it therefore resolved that we, Dr. Willie E. Smith, Chancellor, Baton Rouge Community College, Dr. Ray Belton, President Chancellor, Southern University System, Thomas C. Galligan, Jr., Interim President, Louisiana State University, and the representatives of the Student Government Associations do hereby encourage participation in this endeavor and call our respective community to action. Be it further resolved that a copy of this resolution be given to the appropriate administrative bodies for public display and observation of this effort. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, for your final entertainment tonight, I present the dynamic dance troupe Gold and Blues under the advisement of Connor McGrew.
My father was rich and white. He do they call me? My name is Sophronia. My name is Sophronia. My hair is fine. My hips invite you. My mouth like wine. Whose little girl am I? Anyone who has money to buy. What do they call me? My name is Sweet Thing. My name is Sweet Thing.
Annually, Baton Rouge Community College presents the Unsung Hero Award to a student that has attended the college for at least two semesters with a minimum cumulative GPA of 3.0 or greater, embodies the mission of the college, and is engaged in the campus community through participation in student activities and engages in community service with a spirit of unity as they serve others. This year's recipient is Mr. Kyrus Joseph. Kyrus is a native of Lafayette, Louisiana, majoring in pre-engineering. Dr. Barbara Hasek had this to say in her nomination letter. His academic ability, intellectual prowess, high maturity level, and philanthropic endeavors make him the perfect candidate for this award. In my 15 years of teaching biology major classes at BRCC, Mr. Joseph ranks in the top 1% for academic performance and character. While maintaining a 3.9 cumulative GPA, Kyrus is also a member of the BRCC baseball team. Kyrus also finds time to give back to the community. In 2017, Kyrus and his father founded Kyrus Cares, a nonprofit organization that supports the needs of others. This past year, they've partnered with various COVID-19 relief initiatives, supported food banks, and provided meals for the homeless. We are proud of the accomplishments Kyrus has made in the classroom and in the community. Therefore, without regard, we present the 2021 Unsung Hero Award to Mr. Kyrus Joseph.
Good evening. My name is Wes Heath, and I serve as the MLK Week Program Lead for Louisiana State University. Each year, I have the distinct privilege and honor of selecting a student as the unsung hero within LSU's campus community. Each year, This award goes to a sophomore, junior, senior, or graduate student in good academic standing who embodies the LSU commitment to community and demonstrates positive student involvement and service and displays spirit of humility and unity as they serve diverse populations. Unfortunately, after all of the nominations, we are only allowed to select one winner. This year's winner, however, is not the exception. The winner of LSU's 2021 Unsung Hero Award goes to Exquisite Williams. Exquisite is a junior studying Communication Studies and English in the LSU Honors College. One of their nominees said that Exquisite Williams embodies the LSU's commitment to community through her dedication in making the community a thriving, holistic, and supportive community for Black students and faculty across campus. Exquisite is heavily involved on campus, including their work in the Black Honors Initiative, the Black Caucus through Student Government Association, as a Genesis mentor, as a McNair Scholar, an athletics tutor, and as a lead desk assistant in LaVille Hall. Notably, Exquisite is an influential voice in the student body this past summer in the call to remove Middleton's name, a name with a long associated history of segregationist belief in Louisiana, from the LSU campus library. Exquisite is a powerfully engaged student on campus, one whose impact will persist beyond her time. Another nominator said that Exquisite is more invested than anyone I have met on campus in dismantling systems of inequality within the LSU community. She reflects this in her language, her extracurriculars, and her initiatives. Congratulations, Exquisite, and thank you to all the amazing students who are nominated this year.
Good evening. My name is Cedric Noel, and I am the Union Operations Manager at Southern University. And I have the pleasure of presenting the 2021 recipient of the Unsung Hero for our MLK Unity event. This year's nominee is a 20-year-old senior majoring in elementary education. She is dedicated, passionate, and committed. She is dedicated to making a difference in the lives of others. She is passionate about learning how to effectively teach children. Lastly, she is determined to become a certified teacher. Some of the community service projects that she has completed includes volunteering at the Greater Baton Rouge Food Bank, serving at the Boo with Crew Halloween activity in the Scotlandville community, and reading to pre-K students, and serving as a mentor and student leader within the Office of Student Leadership and Engagement. She volunteers because it warms her heart to know that she is helping someone without receiving anything but a thank you in return. She is happy knowing she has made a difference in someone's life by doing something as simple as paying attention. She currently serves as the president of the Eta Mu chapter of Kappa Delta Pi, which is an international honor society in education. After graduation, she plans to move to Texas and teach with the Katy Independent School District. She aspires to obtain a master's degree in educational leadership at Prairie View A&M College. One of her favorite quotes is, "Doubt kills more dreams than failure ever will." This year's recipient for the 2021 MLK Unity Unsung Hero Award is Ms. DeShayla Kraft. And at this time, I would ask Assistant Professor Dr. Alisa Ross to please join me in presenting her with her award.
Congratulations.
We certainly hope each of you have enjoyed this evening's virtual premiere of our annual MLK Unity Celebration. I'd like to thank our program participants, keynote speaker, awardees, and planning committee for a splendid job well done. This evening's theme, an urgent call for unity and innovation, speaks to what Dr. King once recognized as the fierce urgency of now. In fact, Dr. King said, quote, "We are now faced with the fact that tomorrow is today. We are confronted with the fierce urgency of now. In this unfolding conundrum of life and history, there is such a thing as being too late. This is no time for apathy or complacency. This is a time for vigorous and positive action. May all that has transpired here this evening motivate each of us to answer that urgent call. Thank you, good evening, and may God bless you."